So, since this, if you can see, this point is too far from it. So, obviously, when you are going to double click over it, so there will be a properties window. So, remember that I have double clicked over my point, not the component. Okay, so when I am double clicking over it, I am having certain options to manipulate. First is the name. So, always remember to give your points a name, because it's a best practice. Since it will help you at later stage when you are about to delete when you are about to make any changes to your point or assign new features to your point. So you need to name it. So since this is my right edge of payment, I'm going to simply write EOP underscore R and simply click over the apply. Okay, so my this point has been named as EOP R. Now what? Will changing name is enough? No. You need to look down. There are two constraints. So don't get too much confused by the word constraint, because constraint is nothing. It's only the relation, how this point is linked to other point. So if you see here, this point is having two constraints. One is slope constraint, one is horizontal with respect to this point. Since this point is having currently no name, so let us firstly name this point. I am double clicking and let me name it as CL, which means center line. CL and then simply apply. Now I will check how far this point is from my origin point, from CL. When I am double clicking over it, if you can see constraint 1 and constraint 2, so parent point is CL. That means this point is dependent over this point. Okay, so and how much is in slope? It is a minus 2%, which is my camber, okay, or the cross fall. Suppose I need to change its value, I can simply change here and type my new value and simply click on apply. If I see the second constraint, so it's horizontal and it's 12 meters from center line. It's 12 meter far. So if I change its value from 12 to 3.5, which is obviously a one side road width of a two lane highway, so it's 3.5, and simply click over the apply and notice the change, how that length or the width has reduced for my top the bituminous concrete layer. So here also the sign convention plays an important role. If I zoom in and let you show that this point is in slope of minus 2%. So minus 2% means downwards. If I would have kept it as simply 2%, so it would have moved my point upwards, in upward slope. So you can see the change with the help of signs. Similarly, same case is with your distance, horizontal constraint. So currently it's 3.5, which means right, plus 3.5, which means right. If I would have put my negative sign right over here, so it would have changed the direction and this lane will not be created in the right side. Now it will be created on the left side. Simply if I click apply and you can see the change. So that's why the sign convention is also very important. So at particular point, there's also option for undo. There's also undo command available. So you can just simply undo that if you do any mistake, and make it a habit of going to file and saving your file. So basically, this is my template library. Okay, so template library is basically a collection of all your typical cross sections or templates. So this file is shareable. Suppose you have made three, four cross sections, and now you want to share this template to your other colleague so that he can use the same template, same typical cross sections within his DGM file or on his system. So you need to simply share the file format, which is called ITL. So template library file extension is .itl. You need to share this file, and the file name will be civil templates metric, and it is located in a specific folder of your workspace which you have selected. So it will always be present right over there. So you need to simply go to that folder, simply copy this file, and you can share this file, civil templates metric. As soon as you will share this file, the other colleague can directly import all your templates present within this ITIL file. So I was here, I was explaining like I have created my first layer. And what about thickness and what about the component properties? So since I have only adjusted this point, okay, so if I need to define a certain thickness to my layer, so obviously this thickness seems to be more. So let us check currently by default when I place my simple component, what is the by default thickness? I need to double click over this point. Okay, I can give any name to this point, EOP R2, because since it's a downward point, and check right over here. So it is having two constraints. What are these constraints basically? So let me tell you more about constraints. When you drop down, you are having at least 8 to 9 constraints available. And mostly we use horizontal, vertical, slope, and vector offset. So horizontal means your how much it is like how much horizontal distance, and vertical, how much vertical distance, slope, what is the slope basically, and vector offset is used to locate your point between if you want to follow the slope of two points, then we use a vector offset. So currently this point is having two constraints. One is horizontal and one is vertical. So horizontal, but with respect to which point? So if you can see within the parent EOPR, and if you want to change this point as well, suppose I change my mind, I don't want to make this point constrained to this point. I want to constrain this point with respect to this. So how I'm going to do that? I'm going to select this point picking tool. This is this, if you can see this icon, a very small one. You need to select this and go to back to the drawing and select the point from which you want to make it constrained. So currently this point is constrained with 3.5 meter horizontal distance and 3.5 meter horizontal distance from this point. Okay, so let us change back to the default one. I'm changing back to this point as a constraint. Okay, so now I will be changing its vertical height. I don't want it's a 40 centimeter. I want my height to be just 15 centimeters on the top layer. So I have changed this. I need to change this also. So I will again change 0.4 to 0.15. So this is my first layer ready, which is in 2% camber or crossfall with respect to my center line. My edge of pavement is 2% down with respect to my center line. So, but this is only the one layer component. Okay, so but yet you have not defined any properties to the component. I have just used these points. So in order to define the feature definition, the feature definition means, as in the open nodes, I will repeat again, feature definition means what it is, and feature symbology tells you how it should be displayed, and both are interlinked always. So feature definition always contains information about feature symbology. As soon as you are going to define a feature definition to this component, it will take the shape of whatever the feature symbology is. So when I'm double clicking over this component, so make sure you double click over this component by selecting it's any of the outer boundary. So if you can see the gray bold line, double click over it, and you can give your component a name. So I will just simply name it here, right over here, and give a feature definition since it is of asphalt. So within asphalt, these are the by default feature definitions, but this BC, DBM, OGPC, if you can see these names, these feature definition names are available in your India kit data set. So from there you can get all, but by default, those who have installed a new open roads, they will be getting these layers, TC, asphalt. So you can use even them. Suppose you need to define a top layer, and so you can select asphalt concrete wearing case. Since I'm having this feature definition as BC, so I will select this and simply apply. So note the color change as soon as I click on the apply button. So the complete component turns into gray in color. So basically gray in color, or this color will be reflected when you will be creating, or the software when itself creates a 3D engineered model using your horizontal alignment, vertical alignment, as well as the typical cross section which you are making it here, and then applying it over your center line geometry. So this is only the making window. You are creating your typical cross sections in a digital form. So you are working in a 2D, software itself will create a 3D for you, the 3D typical cross section over your center line, complete along the complete length.